It's the victim's daughter. It's not like it is on TV, is it?
Funny, I was just thinking it's exactly like it is in the show. I'm sitting here literally thinking she is good. She's got a real future ahead of her.
Harley, her father is dead.
I know.
Oh, missed that, Carter.
Oh.
Jerry O'Connell plays a detective in the new comedy series Carter on WGN, which premieres tonight.
We're back on Access Live with our co-host Mike Catherwood, and Jerry joins us now with his shirt on. Thanks for getting nude for us this morning.
Listen, that story really, I got into it. I want to go see if I can become a member of that golf club.
Is that Australia.
Got to apply the sunblock liberally over there.
Your physique looked way too good to be in that golf club.
He was like, no dad bod there.
No dad bod.
No, Mike looks great.
Looking
you
good.
Know it.
Yeah. Let's talk about this show, Carter. So you play, it was a former detective, but in a TV show?
Super fun.
Yeah.
Like right there, that's a great scene in the show. I play an actor who plays a cop on TV, who moves back to his small hometown, and then using his, like, TV detective skills helps them solve crimes. It's a lot like Castle. It's a lot like if you
Grindr.
Well, you got Grindr. Yes. You guys are way too young, but there was a little show called Murder, She
Murder
Wrote.
She Wrote.
Oh, Murder, yes. She Wrote.
You guys, you kids
little
are too
show,
young.
Little show, Angela Lansbury, come on.
I'm like Jessica Fletcher 2.0
yes.
in this show.
I love it. We've been talking about mom guilt. What's it like for you to go back on a series? How's the dad guilt?
Oh, well, I have no guilt. I get the hell out of there immediately. I want nothing to do with them. No, my wife and I are great. My wife, Rebecca Romijn, my wife is busy sometimes and I'm busy. When somebody has to be at home, they're about to enter the fourth grade.
I have a fourth grader who's very handsome.
He's so cute.
And
okay.
You have beautiful fourth grade girls.
Well, let's hook it up.
Boom. I can.
I hope your son doesn't mind me chaperoning them when they're dating and everything.
I'll be there, too. We'll both be chaperoning.
We are. In our house, it's so funny. I used to see back-to-school commercials and get, like, sort of upset. And you get that pit in your stomach, like, we have to go back. Now that I have 2 9-year-olds, I see back-to-school commercials, and my wife and I are like, yeah, well, bye-bye now.
And girls, too. I mean, it's amazing being the father of daughters, but you have two. There's also a special demand where you kind of feel like you don't know what to do. You don't know how to impose your...
Well, yeah. I mean, listen, when it comes to the important conversations, I'm definitely going to have my wife deal with all of those. I did have my daughter once say to me, I had a dream. And I was like, oh, yeah, about what? And she was like, about a boy. And I was like, okay.
Was his name Luke?
Right. And she said, in the dream, we kissed. And I was like, okay, you're going on birth control right now. That's it. These are jokes, of course.
Yeah, of course, yes.
Wait, the best Jerry O'Connell story I've ever heard about your daughters is they couldn't believe that your wife used to be married to Uncle Jesse. It's the greatest thing of all time.
They were huge. They were huge Full House fans, and they came up to me once and said, you know, they love...
This is crazy.
They love the character Uncle Jesse, and I said, you know, get out of here. I thought they were, like, teasing me. A lot of my friends sort of teased me about that, and then I realized they didn't know, and I was like, girls, I'm going to show you something on the internet, and it's going to... It's going to blow your mind.
But now that he's a kid of his own, do Rebecca and John, do they talk at all, or are they friends?
I don't... That's not... That's a previous administration. That's none of my... That's none of my business. I shouldn't even be commenting on it. I do want to comment on... I do think that Colton backstage should be the next Bachelor.
Oh, there it is. Charlie, your brother was the Bachelor.
My brother was the Bachelor 100 years ago, back when the Bachelor was in,
but you,
like,
and Rebecca
black and
were
white.
On it. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we were. I was on it a little bit. But I think Colton should be. Oh, there's my brother right there. I think Colton should be the next Bachelor.
Why?
I think without delving too much into his personal life,
right.
I think... something special in Colton's life could happen.
He's a virgin.
Yes.
And I think we could all be a part of that, and it could be rose ceremony and a deflowering of a rose ceremony. Boom!
That's what I said. We got to take the blush off that rose.
No,
okay.
But he's a great guy. I saw him backstage, and I got to tell you, super hot. You see him in person, and
I like
Colton
this.
Is...
You're
wow.
blushing.
He's a diamond.
I got to tell you, I was a little smitten seeing him.
Wait, is Charlie still with the woman that he chose from The Bachelor?
You know, I am sorry to say this, Bachelor Nation. Sometimes it does not work out. My brother and the young lady that he chose, it didn't work out. I'm sorry, America. You know, things don't work out. Also, my wife is no longer with, you know,
Jesse, of course. Okay, so we're going to find out.
Sometimes relationships, you know, these things happen.
So let's talk about what works and what doesn't work, which in our game, so wrong or so right. Okay, so questions for you that we dug up some research. Shooting Stand By Me, River Phoenix, Corey Feldman, Will Wheaton, Jerry O'Connell.
Sure.
Got up to a lot of mischief in the hotel.
There I am right
True.
There.
True. This included throwing all the poolside furniture in the pool. Did you do this?
We did do that. We threw the poolside furniture into the pool. We weren't terrible kids. We weren't like, you know, committing, I guess that is a crime actually. But it wasn't like terrible crimes. We weren't destroying the furniture, only throwing it in the pool.
Okay, wait, quickly, you were the young quarterback in Jerry Maguire. I love that role for you. Do you do the best Tom Cruise laugh?
Well, I did. I can do like.
Go ahead.
I don't want to make too much fun of him. That Mission Impossible 6 was awesome.
Was it?
Really good. And he broke his leg. He does his own stunts. I do want to say, in Carter on WGN America tonight, I do none of my own stunts. Stuntmen who come in and do
honesty.
All,
they make it
way better than I could. I'm scared. Tom Cruise is a real man. I am not.